Hello, everyone. Welcome to actually quite a beautiful day here in Fallout 4. It's one of the things I really like about this game. It's how gorgeous the scenery is. Even with all the dead trees, it's so much more colorful than Fallout 3, which was really kind of bleak and dreary. Anyway, I haven't recorded in a few days due to rampant migraines, which is the number one thing most likely to keep me from recording when I want to. But I'm back. I admit that I did run around a little bit in the game off camera. I couldn't resist, really. Wandered around in that direction a bit, got ambushed by mole rats, and went down that way, I think, and met Dog Meat, who is a wonderful, lovely puppy dog, and I love him. I love Dog Meat. Anyway, but I reloaded back to where I left off recording, so let's go down and check out the old neighborhood, and then get Dog Meat again as soon as possible. Wait, okay, I want to look around. Is there anything that I can loot in these old... ooh, abandoned vehicles? I don't think so. It doesn't look like it. Maybe? Anything in... ooh. Hello, skeleton. A desk fan. Cram. That sounds wonderful and yummy. Okay. And more coffee cups, because I don't have enough coffee cups at this point. Oh, all the people who are outside the gate trying to get in. Well, that's pleasant. Ooh, wait. Is that... ooh. Something I can harvest. Now, the question is, what is it actually good for? I guess we'll find out. And I will probably spend as much time picking flowers in this game as I do in Skyrim. Which is a lot, even though I try not to do it too much when I'm actually recording. Speaking of not doing too much of that while I'm recording... is that another plant? What can I harvest? Things that are colorful. I can talk. Is this water dangerous to stand in? I don't seem to be getting any radiation from it. I thought I saw a thing, but I didn't see a thing after all. Okay, let's actually go into the neighborhood and see if we can progress the plot a little bit. Maybe. I mean, I'm not gonna get too much into the plot in these videos, but I at least want to see a little bit of it. And here's the old house.
As I live and breathe!
Hello, Codsworth.
It's really you!
So, I could... you know, I don't know which... like, what is really the difference between these options? This seems to be the kind of blunt option. This is... friendly?
Cat got your tongue, Mum?
Yes. I'll go with this one.
Oh my god. This can't be happening. This isn't happening.
Isn't happening? What are you talking about? My, but you look distraught. Perhaps Sir can offer one of those bugs you humans are so fond of. Speaking of which, where is your better half?
Well, see, there's the thing.
Oh, Mum, these things you're saying, these...
And skipped over the dialogue.
I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades.
Oh, that Sean sounds like a wonderful
so
idea.
Love that game. Is the lad with you?
As a matter of fact, no. Have you seen him?
Codsworth, listen to me carefully. Have you seen him? Have you seen Sean?
Why, sir, had him last, remember? Perhaps he's gone to the Parker residence to arrange a play date.
Somehow I don't think
I'm
so.
I'm sure he'll be back with him momentarily.
Why would we be arranging a play date with a tiny infant, anyway? I'm pretty sure Sean is too young for friends at this point. Okay, Sean has been kidnapped.
Sean's been kidnapped. And I'm gonna find him. I'm gonna get my baby back.
It's worse than I thought. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
That's impossible.
No, that's not possible. I wasn't out for that long. Not 200 years.
A bit over 210, actually, Mum. Give or take a little for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack. You must be famished.
He seems awfully cheerful. Okay, so at times people withhold information or Okay, successfully persuading someone is indicated by color, yellow easy, orange medium, red hard. Okay.
Take all the time you need.
Thank you, I will. Okay, let's try persuading.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird. What's wrong?
Mum, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve.
Oh, poor Codsworth.
I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing. And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Okay, let's focus, Codsworth.
Whoa. Focus, Codsworth.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, Mum. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe Sir was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
So what's on this holotape?
A holotape? What's on it?
I believe it's a private message for you. My etiquette protocols would not permit me to play it for myself. Any standard holotape reading device should be able to play it back. Oh, like that Pip-Boy on your arm. That should work brilliantly.
Now, right.
Enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? Sir and young Sean may turn up yet.
Somehow, I don't think they're just going to turn up, but, let's see.
Have you seen anything dangerous?
Oh, just the usual, Mum. Pesky neighborhood dogs and mosquitoes. Shall I investigate?
All right. Go ahead.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, Mum!
The whole voiced protagonist thing is really annoying me at this point, especially since It's almost identical to what I actually say out loud, and then she just repeats what I was going to say.
Terrific! It's a fight then!
Is it? Where? Oh. Is it more bugs? Whoa. Hello. Oh, let's try... No, that's not what I meant to do. Let's try that. No. Let's try that on the actual intended target. And then...
My senses are picking up movement in another house. Follow me!
Alright. I'm gonna have to come back later and loot things. Which house are we going to? Oh. Yes, I see something flying around. Where is it? Haha! More bats. I'm gonna use this a lot. Because I will be honest, I'm pretty useless at guns. Is there another one? I'm pretty terrible with guns. I don't play many games that use them.
Your family isn't here either. They're really gone, aren't they?
It looks like that.
Sean's out there, Codsworth. I need to find him.
What about Concord, Mum? Few people there. And last I checked, they only pummeled me with sticks a few times before I had to run back home.
I don't want to be mean to Codsworth, but I could be a little sarcastic.
I like these people already.
Oh, good! Maybe they'll get along then, and they can help you find young Sean.
I shall remain here and secure the home front.
Okay, you do that, then. The other thing I don't like about the dialogue system, that I like even less than the voiced protagonist, is that the options don't give me a good enough sense of what I'm actually going to say. Because sarcastic could be mean sarcastic, or it could be friendly sarcastic, but there's no real indication from what the dialogue wheel says. And some of the options it's given me haven't really given me a sense of what the difference is between what the dialogue will be. They just don't seem different enough to know what kind of tone or what kind of personality they would show. Okay, enough complaining about the dialogue. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to spend some time looting the neighborhood off camera so that you don't have to suffer through all of that, but I will be ready to record again in case I come up against anything interesting while I'm running around. And then I'll start recording again when it's time to, I guess, go down to Concord. And I'm assuming that's the same direction that I went to meet Dogmeat, so that'll be fun. I'll see you in a bit. Okay, so I've been looting that side of the neighborhood. Managed to break my one bobby pin trying to open up a safe that I found. But I'm stopping here because that appears to be a lit lantern, which makes me a little nervous. I'm wondering if there are actual people hanging out in this neighborhood. I have seen signs that people have been here since the bomb. Found some caps and such. Also found my first bottle of Nuka-Cola, which makes me happy. But this makes me a little nervous. So I'm gonna go in here carefully. Actually, maybe I should sneak. I'm detected by Codsworth, probably. Let's hope. Well, maybe if there is somebody in here, they're friendly. No bugs. No. Another lantern. Huh. Okay. No one here, apparently. Ooh, bobby pins. And a stim pack, which is also good. Alright. Sunglasses. So, what's up with the lantern? Ooh! That must be what's up with the lantern. Okay, I was trying to put away my gun, but that took a while. Weapons workbench. So, I cannot upgrade the security baton. That's fine with me. What can I do? Okay. R for scrap, which I probably don't want to do, except that I have 3 of these. I can rename it. Well, that's interesting. I'm not going to rename it now, but let's take a look at the... How do I look at... Okay. Okay, so there are different categories for what I can upgrade, and it seems like I have some mods available. Lighter weight, reduced damage. Interesting. Comfort grip. Improved recoil and hip fire accuracy. That sounds good to me. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Okay. Oh, okay, so it takes apart the junk that I collect. That's why I'm collecting all this junk. All right. There is a reason for me to pick up everything. Which I would probably do anyway. Okay, let's do it. Anything else that I can upgrade? Doesn't look like it at the moment. I need to collect more junk before I can do that. But I guess I'll... Maybe I can find some place to sell these? Or maybe it would be better to just scrap them. I'll scrap them. No, not modify. That's not what I meant to do. R for scrap. So I'll get 5 steel out of that. This looks worse in pretty much every way. Except that it's lighter. Oh, and it has a faster fire rate. I'm gonna go ahead and scrap that too. And one of the security... And one of the security batons, I'll keep the other. Okay. Okay. Enter to exit. Modding and crafting stations and workshop locations will automatically share items you store in them, but only if you've unlocked the workshop in their location. What does that mean? Power armor station, which I cannot open. So, another... Okay, so this is the workshop. The workshop allows you to build, adjust, and remove nearby objects and structures. Move to between options with the arrows. Press the up arrow to find the object or structure you wish to build. If your selected object appears green, press E to build it. If it appears red, try adjusting its location and yours until it changes to green. I don't quite understand what this is trying to tell me. Workshop objects are built from components. That makes sense. Automatically harvested from junk items. Okay. So, I can still look around. I can still move. Interesting. Wait a minute. Why are these highlighted? What can I do with them? Can I... Oh. Wait. I can scrap things lying around. Okay. That... I thought I scrapped that. Okay. Then there's... Oh, okay. Wait, arrow keys to navigate through here. Okay, Interesting. I'm gonna spend some time looking at these later, but I think for now, what was it? Up arrow key? I can make furniture. Interesting. Let's make a chair. I need... different materials depending on what I want to make. Huh. Let's make this chair. Won't let me. Why won't it let me? Oh. Okay. And is there a way to turn it around? No, that is not what I wanted to do. Oh, okay. So right mouse button lets me rotate the item, and then I can just not put it there because it's in the middle of tires. I can put it there. Let me just set this down somewhere random next to the workbench. And E for build. I made a chair. Okay. What else can I do? Cancel the chair. I don't want to build more chairs. Are there any other... What's that? Armor workbench. What? I meant to use the armor workbench, but apparently I just picked it up. Let's put that back down. There, I guess. That's close enough to where it was originally. Okay. And then, I guess, I can scrap whatever is yellow. Yeah, I can scrap things. Like this rubble that's... Wait. Wait a second. This whole thing is highlighted. I can scrap a house? I can scrap a house! I just scrapped a house. Ooh, this is gonna be fun. I can scrap all sorts of things. I'm probably gonna spend way too much time cleaning up this entire neighborhood. Which maybe is the point? What is... Okay, what's that glowing? What is that? That... It's like... Oh, outside buildable area. Oh, okay. Just pulled me out of the workshop. Okay. Good to know. It's getting dark. And I don't think I'm gonna spend too much more time in crafting right now. I wanna check out the armor workshop, though. Wait a second. Transfer. What can I put in here? I can... Okay, so is that stuff that I already put into the workshop? There's a bunch of materials and some objects. And then I can take things, or I can store all junk. That's useful. Okay, so how many coffee cups do I have at this point? 16 coffee cups. I have a feeling I'm going to be getting a lot of coffee cups. I don't know if they're going to be very useful, but I'm going to pick them up anyway. Because they'll probably come in handy at some point for something. Oh. This game is going to encourage all of my worst tendencies when it comes to keeping things that I probably don't really need. Okay, I do want to look at the armor workshop, the workbench, not workshop. No mods. Should I scrap the other jumpsuits or should I keep them? I think I'm gonna keep them. That reminds me, though, that I picked up some clothes while I was wandering around. So I would actually like to take a look at my clothes. Which I do in here somewhere. Let's see if I remember how to navigate anything. Okay. Aha. I have a couple of suits. A pretty, pretty dress. Let's see how pretty this dress is. Okay. Not very practical for wandering around a post-apocalyptic wasteland, but nice. How about a blue suit? I don't think that fits her very well. Unfortunate. Okay, let's put the jumpsuit back on. Wait, so what do these do? Charisma. And charisma. Somehow I think the damage resistance is going to be more useful right now. What about the sunglasses? Perception, same as the eyeglasses. I'll go with sunglasses, I think. They're pretty much the same thing. Okay. Check the mailbox, nothing there. Looks like the mail hasn't been delivered in about 200 years. Alright. I'm gonna keep looting the neighborhood. I don't think I want to venture out while it's dark. So I will see you next time I see something interesting around the neighborhood, or when I head out towards Concord.